I don't think I ever gave in my life such a speculative talk as this one, so... In fact, when I announced this title, I hope to have more dreams, but kind of somehow I didn't have enough sleeps to have some. What?
The flight is long, the
airport. Okay. Yeah, but I was.
Could also afford a nightmare.
Nightmares. Okay, anyway. So, a couple years ago, was a conference here. And I was giving a talk about some kind of development and flexible side of symplectic topology. And I kind of declared kind of the following optimistic principle that in symplectic topology, just there is a beyond holomorphic curve, there is nothing but H principles, so kind of like whatever is not restricted by holomorphic curve theory is in fact can be constructed and it exists. And I kind of my talk today is in a little bit in the similar spirit. So when I was talking then Fukai was in the audience and he asked me questions kind of, but can you just make some precise statement? What does that mean? I still cannot make a precise statement, but kind of let me kind of say a few more words in this direction.
It was last year, not previous.
It's last year. Okay. Oh, okay. Okay. So I have some kind of justification that I didn't have too many nights to dream of. So, okay. So again, kind of like my general kind of direction is the following: that there is a in symplectic topology there is this methods coming from the theory of holomorphic curve or in its different incarnations, and there are some kind of results many wonderful results were proven in this direction, especially this holomorphic curve theory is powerful in dimension 4. For instance, in dimension 4, Gromov proved that there is a unique symplectic structure on R4, and kind of essentially if you have a symplectic manifold which is a standard at infinity look like R4 at infinity, then with the addition of Duse-McDuff the result is that it's in fact is a R4 up to maybe blow ups. So in high dimensions, kind of this holomorphic curve, the same type of idea, they give only topological result, kind of. So there's also result by Flor, McDuff, myself, that we said in high dimension, if you have a, using something just differential topology, you can prove that if the manifold is standard like R2n at infinity, then it is standard provided, topologically provided. That's, for instance, there is no holomorphic curve in this manifold. But then this is a kind of completely different type of result. So also, like in dimension four, in the similar vein, there is a result we proved with Polterovich that if you have a Lagrangian submanifold in R4, which is at infinity look like R2, then this Lagrangian submanifold is R2 up to Hamiltonian isotopy. So in high dimension, using all, again, powerful holomorphic curve methods, we have a lot of results about constraining. For instance, it's known that this manifold has to be R2n if it has this property. And kind of, but we don't know whether it's... There's absolutely no I think Hoppe using this holomorphic curve to prove that it's in fact Hamiltonian as a topic to this, some kind of version of this so-called nearby Lagrangian conjecture. And my point is that probably because this is difficult, because we're kind of looking this problem in the long wrong domain. So this is already part. So this type of results already belongs to H principle, and then you need to prove it with H principle type statement. And I would kind of be talking something in this direction about. So let me first review just few kind of recent development in the flexible side of symplectic topology. So kind of two main flexible object which we know in symplectic topology, and they are kind of start with contact world. They are over-twisted contact manifold. And there is a notion of loose Legendrian knots due to Emmy Murphy. So what is a over-twisted contact manifold? Again, it's maybe it's not so important precise definition. There is a nowadays many equivalent definition of this. But for instance, one of this definition is the following: that you take a let me use the following definition. So in dimension, it's a mostly known kind of in dimension three, and then in dimension three, it just says that there is a certain disk which is a tangent in the contact three manifold, which is a tangent along the boundary to contact structure. And in high dimension, you can say that kind of one of the equivalent definition, which is in fact due to Presses, Murphy, and Casals. This says that manifold is over-twisted if it contains a product of such disk with arbitrary large contact ball, for instance. That's one of equivalent. But doesn't matter. The important thing that it's the contact manifold is over-twisted if there is a certain particular, contains certain particular virus. So there is some kind of embedding of something, and the something can be very small, and it sits there, and somehow this kind of implantation of this virus makes the whole thing very flexible. So in the same sense, there is a Legendrian knot, and this is a notion of loose Legendrian knot is technically it's a notion So first we introduced with Fraser this notion of over-twisted contact three manifold, meaning that this is a Legendrian knot whose complement is over-twisted. But then turns out that there's a various object with very similar property exists in high-dimensional contact manifold, and in any contact manifold of dimension greater than three. And again, doesn't matter what is particular definition. For instance, there is a certain local construction called stabilization, which you can make with Legendrian knot, and you can define this Legendrian knot is loose if it's isotopic to stabilization of some other knots. So again, any Legendrian knot can be made loose via some local modification. And again, this is a similar situation that as soon as you have this smallest kind of this loose virus, then it makes the object completely flexible. So there is a, on the first glance, these are kind of two different objects, but they are tightly related. So this loose Legendrian knot and over-twisted contact manifold are tightly related objects. For instance, I don't think there is a such theorem, kind of, at least the theorem exists in kind of proven, probably half of the theorem is proven, but I'm sure the second half is also true, which says the following thing. So given, you see, given any manifold, contact manifold, then with this contact manifold, you can make its kind of like, given symplectic manifold, there is this kind of standard construction of symplectic square, taking product of the symplectic manifold with this manifold with the opposite symplectic structure. And the same you do with contact manifold. You take contact manifold, you symplectize it. That means you multiply by R, so you get this symplectic manifold, and then you take this symplectic manifold with kind of like inverted symplectic structure here, and in this manifold you have this product and you have this diagonal, and there is a diagonal action here by you can quotient by this R action here, and then you get a contact manifold, and the diagonal now after this quotient, so you get new contact manifold, and you get this kind of again Lagrangian diagonal remaining with Legendrian boundary. So you get our diagonal as a Legendrian submanifold in this product construction. And the kind of theorem which should be true that this manifold is overtwisted if and only if this diagonal is loose. So there is a kind of, so I think in one direction it's pretty easy, and this Roger Casals, I think, proved this, that it is, if it's over twisted, that it's loose, but in the opposite direction, I'm sure it also should be true. So also, kind of, there are other, many other kind of connection between this looseness and over twisting. For instance, suppose you have a contact manifold, and you have a Legendrian submanifold. And then you can always have a construction, given Legendrian submanifold, you can attach a Lagrangian handle to this. So attach symplectic handle, like thinking about this, our contact manifold is a boundary of this symplectic manifold of kind of part of its symplectization, you can attach a handle to this. And this handle by itself is just cotangent bundle of a disk, of n-dimensional disk. And so you can just attach, and the boundary of the disk itself is Legendrian submanifold along the boundary, and you attach it. But also, of course, you have this disk and you have that disk, and you can also kind of subtract a handle. Kind of like attach a handle to this manifold. So you have also this construction. And so you get a cobordism between our original contact manifold and another contact manifold on negative side of this one. And if the Legendrian knot is loose, then the result is overtwisted. So this is, again, kind of simple, pretty fact. So, as I said, these two notions are tightly related. And what I'm kind of, in fact, in my talk, I will be trying to explore this notion kind of parallel between kind of different version things, statement about Legendrian knot, not necessarily loose, and contact manifold further. So, of course, another kind of, let me list few more kind of analogies between this loose Legendrian situation and over-twisted contact. So one common feature that holomorphic curve theory completely fails in both cases. So if you have an over-twisted contact manifold of dimension greater than 3, dimension 3, there is, again, special situation because of all this embedded contact homology and kind of another stuff kind of related to gauge theory. But in high dimension, if you try to define, for instance, this quantum homology algebra or any kind of invariant based on holomorphic curve, you get nothing. So get, everything, this algebra is identically equal to zero. Similarly, there is a relative version of all this SFT-type invariants for Legendre and some manifold. For instance, you can define this Legendre and homology algebra also for this manifold. And again, if it's loose, it's identically zero. And so like, there is absolutely no way of extracting any invariants out of holomorphic curve. And hence, this was a motivation for me and for Murphy, in fact, to prove flexibility, that in fact, there is nothing, and you can prove the result. So here you can prove in our twisted case that any almost contact structure is homotopic to genuine contact, over-twisted contact structure, and two over-twisted contact structure, if they kind of formally homotopic, they are homotopic. And exactly the same result held in the Legendre category. So another kind of result which we have in Legendrian world is then when we're looking at Lagrangian manifold with Legendrian boundaries, then this N Legendrian boundary is on negative end. So we consider the symplectic manifold with negative contact boundary. So that means that there is a symplectic manifold and there is a some hypersurface d minus w equal, say, sigma. And you have a Lagrangian submanifold with boundary on this sigma. And this is negative boundary in the sense that our symplectic form is exact near this boundary. And it is dual as a corresponding Liouville vector field. If you consider corresponding Liouville vector field, then it enters our manifold. It's a negative boundary. Then, if this Legendrian boundary is loose, then it's very easy to construct Lagrangian manifold with Legendrian boundary. Any formal Lagrangian class is realized by such Lagrangian manifold. And again, you have a complete H principle. If the two such things are formally isotopic, they are Legendrian, they are Lagrangian isotopic. Hamiltonian isotopic even. Kind of course, you require boundary need to be allowed to move. So I'm slightly lying because this is true, provided this is I think this is an infinite end. And during this isotopy, this Lagrangian may be movable kind of, I may be changing this Lagrangian at some compact part, but not at infinity. So in other words, when you take a Lagrangian, and then you kind of spoil this Lagrangian with one singular point. Again, you kind of have this virus in this Lagrangian manifold, which look like cone over this Legendrian knot, which is loose. Then such object is completely flexible. There is, again, no symplectic topology. And again, kind of like another feature of this, if you try to define any holomorphic curve invariants for such thing, you will fail because somehow they all disappear in this black hole. So now let's look at this symplectic counterpart for this. Sorry, just on this side. So we have now kind of natural to assume that when we consider now symplectic manifold. So we consider now symplectic manifold with contact boundary, with negative contact boundary. And if this boundary is over-twisted, then this object should become completely flexible. So like it should be easy to construct symplectic structure on manifold with this kind of one singular conical point. Again, I'm talking about manifold of dimension at least 6. Dimension 4 is very special. So with a singular conical point, and singular conical point, and such that near this point, this our symplectic form look like symplectization of some overtwisted contact structure on the boundary. So indeed, kind of, unfortunately. So we proved with Amy Murphy some result in this direction, but unfortunately not quite this, and I very much hope that this is also true in this form, but let me formulate what did we prove. So we proved the following result. So suppose you have we started with Kobordis.
Yasha, why doesn't this diagonal trick just work again for this? Embed this thing in the diagonal, then you're now in this picture you just discussed. Why is that not?
What embed in the diagonal?
So I mean the same trick you used before. Then you should have this thing sitting in the diagonal as.
But how I get it back? So I from symplectic manifold I can get this Lagrangian, but how from the Lagrangian I can get symplectic manifold? I don't know.
So you learned that there's something, but maybe not the same shape as this step weight.
Yeah, but if you have a symplectic manifold, then you get Lagrangian diagonal. But if you have a kind of, I construct, so I don't know what. Okay. Anyway, so we have a, so suppose we started with some smooth cobordism. So we started with smooth cobordism between two manifold, D minus and D plus. And, well, we want to make this cobordism into symplectic manifold and with contact boundary. So we prescribe here some contact structure and prescribe here some contact structure. And we want this to be negative contact boundary and this is positive contact boundary. So we want to construct symplectic manifold, which is at near the boundary, look like symplectization, kind of negative and positive symplectization of corresponding contact boundary. And so we want to construct it, but of course you need to have almost complex structure in order to do that. And the theorem is the following, that so this is a theorem of Murphy myself that so in this situation again dimension let us assume so dimension is at least 6 so then you can always find some Liouville form lambda so it's a Liouville form Liouville form on W such that okay so lambda on D minus W is defines C minus or lambda D plus minus define C plus minus on the boundary and this again negative in positive boundary provided, so this is Liouville form. That means that d lambda is symplectic compatible with J. Provided that the following conditions: that first of all, this C minus is overtwisted, this contact structure negative n is overtwisted, and unfortunately, I need the condition that this boundary. Upper boundary is not empty. So in this situation, this thing with boundary which is non-empty, you can always construct symplectic cobordism on such thing if this is overtwisted. So there is a Using this result, which I told you before, that the surgery on kind of inverse surgery on loose Legendre knot is on loose Legendre knot is overtwisted, you can easily to prove the following result, that you have a always in dimension greater than 4, you can always find concordance between any contact structure and overtwisted contact structure. So there is a, if you take a manifold and multiply manifold by interval, then you can find on this manifold symplectic structure always in dimension beginning not 4, where this thing is any contact structure and this overtwisted. You can just kind of use this fact. And this was observation of Casals, Murphy, and Presses. And so therefore, this statement, you can replace it by just assuming that both boundaries are overtwisted, because positive boundary, you can replace any contact boundary by overtwisted using this trick. So essentially the statement that you have a two overtwisted contact structure and you have any topological cobordism between them, almost complex, you can make it symplectic. And in high dimension, this is true in all dimensions, including 4, but in high dimension, this is in addition implies that contact structure on the positive boundary could be standard. So in particular, notice that what we get a symplectic structure. You can take any manifold. So take suppose now, say, M to N is any closed manifold. And then any closed manifold, and say, let's suppose it almost it's a almost complex in a complement of one point. So there is a almost complex structure in the complement of one point. And then you can first delete some small ball of this and make this into some kind of cobordism, which is a look like standard R to N, standard contact structure at infinity. And you're asking, is it possible to construct symplectic structure on this manifold? So you have this manifold minus point, and you want on the manifold minus point to construct symplectic structure which is standard at infinity. So the theorem which I mentioned just at the beginning of Laure, MacDuff, myself, that this manifold topology, if it's really symplectic structure, topology is fantastically restricted. Essentially, it just have to be R to N. But if I allow one singular point, and this singular point will be like cone over twisted contact structure on a sphere, then you can do it on any symplectic manifold. So in particular, it answers this question which I said in following ways, that you take any manifold which you want to make a symplectic, and then if you connected some with already another manifold which is symplectic, then this manifold always admits a symplectic structure with one conical point. Okay. But also, as I hope that in this situation, much stronger feasibility result holds. First of all this completely should be unnecessary. And moreover, you should have a kind of even parametric version of this. Just symplectic topology of this manifold should be kind of non-existent. So this was a still not dream, it was a result, except that this was a like small piece of dream. So let me kind of now move to more to dream part. So in again, let's kind of try to push this analogy between this Lagrangian, the relative and closed situation further. So in I was talking about this kind of symplectic caps and Lagrangian caps, thing with negative boundary. But of course, we're much more interested with thing with positive boundary. So suppose you have a like Weinstein manifold. So Weinstein manifold. So you're thinking about this as a kind of, well, we can think about it as some symplectic handle body. So we started with say ball, and we started to attach handle along this first isotropic manifold, and we get some kind of manifold which is a what is called subcritical, and then you start to attach handle along Legendrian submanifold, and you get this Weinstein handle body. So you get this manifold. So you get a manifold with contact boundary. So this is kind of important class of this manifold. Of course, all Stein manifold like this. Of course, all affine algebraic manifold like this. So it's important class of symplectic manifold, and we would like to understand their symplectic topology. So it was known since long time ago that this subcritical Weinstein manifold are not so interesting in the sense that if there is no handle of middle index, then this manifold is its symplectic topology is determined by its pure topology, and again it's manifested in some kind of holomorphic statement that the symplectic homology vanishes. So this was generalized by in our book Viskai Chilibak to some class which we call flexible Weinstein manifold. So flexible Weinstein manifold means it's first of all, it's object, again, of dimension greater than 4. It's always starting from 6. And flexible Weinstein manifold, this is the handle body where all critical handles attached along loose Legendrian knot. Or kind of more precisely to say, if you kind of attach them simultaneously, they have to be attached along what is called loose Legendrian link. That means that every attaching Legendrian sphere have to be loose as a complement of the rest. So this loose Weinstein manifold, Weinstein handle body, again have vanishing symplectic homology, and again we prove that they are satisfy kind of complete H principle in a sense that any manifold which potentially can be Weinstein manifold admits this loose, flexible Weinstein structure, and any two such structure are homotopic provided that they are formally in the same class. So the question. So there is on first glance, this is a kind of, again, non-interesting object, flexible Weinstein manifold. But not quite, because contact boundary of this flexible Weinstein manifold still have a very, very non-trivial contact structure. For instance, the theorem of Oleg Lazarev says that if you have a such manifold, that contact structure, if you know that you have a contact manifold and its contact manifold bound this flexible Weinstein manifold, then this boundary, then the contact boundary, contact structure, remember, for instance, homology, rank of homology of this manifold. And in fact, it's we have some kind of work in progress with Lazarev and Ganatra, kind of saying that in fact much more subtle topology remembered by contact structure. So it's not completely obvious, kind of in the first glance, because of course it's straightforward to because the symplectic homology trivial, then what is called linearized contour homology have to be isomorphic to what is called SH plus symplectic homology, which is determined by the boundary, have to be equivalent to homology of the manifold. But this thing depends, definition depends on limitation, which depends on the filling. So the fact that it's independent of filling is not a trivial fact. So anyway, as I'm saying, that still boundary is kind of interesting of this object contactly. So also things here turns out to be much more subtle than kind of what we thought with Chilibac at the beginning. So there is a recent work of Kyler Ziegel and Amy Murphy, which says that answers the following question, which we ask whether flexibility is invariant under Weinstein homotopy. So suppose you take a Weinstein structure and deform this Weinstein structure in the class of Weinstein structure. And the question is, it remain flexible? And kind of like critical question is the following. So suppose you have some Weinstein structure on flexible manifold, and you have some Weinstein sublevel set. Is it flexible? For instance, it also have to have trivial homology, but turns out there is an example when it's not flexible. So the sublevel set of Weinstein function can, on flexible manifold, for kind of wrong Weinstein function, can be not flexible. So things are pretty kind of subtle here. Okay, but let's move to to the rally, to these dreams. So what is the analog of flexible Weinstein manifold in the Lagrangian Legendrian category? So suppose you have now this Weinstein manifold, and you have a Legendrian submanifold on the boundary, and now we have a Lagrangian submanifold.
You came right in time.
Yes.
Started his talk about dreams.
We have a Lagrangian submanifold with this Legendrian boundary. So I'm talking that this is a Weinstein manifold with contact boundary, and we have a Legendrian submanifold with Lagrangian boundary. So as I just kind of, let me just say two words for you, that there is a, in this in the class of Weinstein manifold, there exists this class what is called flexible Weinstein manifold, where this, you have a kind of handle body construction where top dimensional index and handle attach along loose Legendrian nodes. And this object have this kind of like symplectic topology disappear on this one. And so my question, kind of like all this theme of my talk, is kind of to try to have this analog of this result, analogous result in relative situation and the closed situation. So suppose we have a Lagrangian, now you have a simply this Weinstein manifold with contact boundary and Lagrangian submanifold Legendrian boundary. So I would like to call, what does it mean that L is flexible? So there is a, of course, some obvious example when what we want to be flexible. So this is a, by the way, what I'm talking is again part of kind of something which we are again discussing currently with Shil Ganatra and Oleg Lazarev. So so one obvious example. So you started with this W, and you take this product of this W with kind of inverse symplectic structure, and in this product you have this Lagrangian diagonal. Right? So you have this Lagrangian diagonal, and this Lagrangian diagonal has this Legendrian boundary. So I want this to be flexible if my W flexible. So this is kind of one important example. So the second example which I want is the following. So suppose I have any Weinstein manifold, and now suppose I'm attaching this handle along this loose Legendrian knot. So loose Legendrian knot, by the way, they cannot bound the exact, I'm actually interested in exact Lagrangian submanifolds, I can say this. So they cannot bound exact Lagrangian submanifold because if they do, then this what kind of holomorphic curve theory prohibits this. But now this Lagrangian, this handle which I attach has this co-core holomorphic, co-core Lagrangian disk. So there is I attached, this is a core disk and there is a co-core disk. And I want this co-core disk in this case to be flexible Weinstein manifold, flexible Lagrangian manifold. So what is a kind of natural definition? Well, so here's a kind of conjectural definition what flexible Lagrangian manifold is. So this is the following object. So notice that this when we consider when we consider this Weinstein handle, kind of critical Weinstein handle, this is a cotangent bundle of n-dimensional disk. And this handle, of course, contain two obvious Lagrangian disk. This is a zero section and the fiber, but it also, you can take a conormal bundle. You can take a conormal bundle of
the full cotangent bundle part of it. The full cotangent bundle.
I take a disk bundle. I take a
cotangent disk bundle.
Cotangent
one.
Okay. Cotangent disk bundle of this one. So you have this just handle, and now you can take a conormal bundle of some subdisk of smaller dimension. So if you take if this k is equal n, then this is our core. If k is equal 0, this is co-core, but there are all intermediate things. So there are a lot of this Lagrangian disk. And what I want when I do this my handle body, if I do my handle body, then I attach handles simultaneously. Simultaneously to the manifold and submanifold, right? So another way, like if you're talking in terms of, so you have this pair WL, and you have this Morse function on this pair, and I want this critical point. I want this critical points of phi restricted to L are also critical points of phi itself. So when I attach, so each time I have a say contact manifold and my Lagrangian comes to some Legendrian submanifold. And now I have a attaching sphere for the handle, which is again Legendrian, and this attaching sphere need to intersect my boundary of my Lagrangian manifold. what is called cleanly along, it's non-transversely, but along some sphere, some equatorial sphere of smaller dimension. And then when you attach this handle, you attach kind of smaller handle, which is one of this conormal disk to this Lagrangian submanifold. So I always my critical points, always critical points on Weinstein manifold are of index n, but on Lagrangian that can be of arbitrary index. So this is this picture. But now what is the flexibility condition? So flexibility condition is the following, that first this critical points of phi of index n. I always want them of index
n. Condition or definition?
This is a definition. This is a definition. It's a Dicke condition of the definition.
And doesn't always exist.
I don't know if it exists or not. It's a question. So, okay. Yeah. So suppose such thing exists. Suppose such thing exists, and in addition, I want the following condition. So first of all critical point of phi over L are of index less than n. So on my Lagrangian submanifold, I am not allowing critical points of top index. For instance, this Lagrangian cannot be closed. It must have a boundary. So second, I want, so each time when I have this attaching sphere, which intersect my boundary of Lagrangian along, so this is some attaching sphere, Legendrian, and intersect this boundary along some equatorial sphere, I want this sphere to be loose in the complement of this intersection. So this kind of virus is somewhere have to be outside of this intersection. So such Lagrangian is, if you have, we call it flexible. So if you can find on our manifold Weinstein function, which have this property.
Yasha, what was this line in that sphere? What's this line? No, in your picture of the sphere, the intersection.
So I have a contact manifold. In the contact manifold, you have already, we started with I'm building handle body. So I have already this my manifold and already piece of Lagrangian submanifold. And now I'm attaching handle. And I'm attaching handle along some Legendrian sphere. And this, I denoted this S, and this is DL. So this is a boundary of the Lagrangian, and this is a this Legendrian along which I attach, which required to intersect this along some sphere of equator sphere. And kind of I simultaneously attach handle to both of them. Of course, this also have a very transparent interpretation in terms of this Lefschetz handle body picture, right? So if you have this Lefschetz, now with all this work of beginning from Donaldson and kind of latest of Giroux-Pardon, so we know we can take a Weinstein manifold and you can kind of present it as follows. So there exists Lefschetz vibration over the disk with some bunch of this critical Lefschetz fiber. And the fiber itself is this Weinstein submanifold of smaller dimension. So we have this Lefschetz presentation. And now nobody kind of proved this yet, I think, but certainly this is true, that there is this kind of, it can be proven in the same spirit as all this Giroux-Pardon result, that if you have a Lagrangian submanifold in this Weinstein manifold, then you can find this Lefschetz picture in such a way that this Lagrangian submanifold will project to certain ray going to the boundary. So this such result exists in closed case, but kind of this should be true also in this relative case. And then in this case, so this our Lagrangian would would pass through the bunch of this critical point of this Lefschetz fibration, and like it will be precisely like I'm looking at this complex analytic function, and in, on our Lagrangian manifold, it's a take a real value. So it's kind of real analytic, complex analytic extension of real analytic function, kind of this, this is the picture. So then this kind of this, the handle, this Weinstein handle here are exactly, will be this thimbles of this critical points, kind of core of the Weinstein handle. So anyway.
Yasha, can you see the flexibility in that picture?
Well, I wish I could see the flexibility in absolute case in this picture. I don't know. So this is a, we don't know. This is, I think, a kind of like, well, we have a world expert here, Kyler Ziegel, in this sitting in this audience. But I think, I guess he was thinking a lot about this. So, but I don't think it's understood what flexibility means in terms of Lefschetz picture. But anyway, so the answering to I think Joel's, I forgot whose question was this, that I think, or it's your question, or somebody asked question, that I think for every Lagrangian manifold, such presentation exists. But when it's flexible or not flexible, of course, it's a subtle question.
So what was the condition that made it flexible?
Condition flexible that all these handles are Legendrian manifolds. So definition of flexibility for closed case that all these Legendrian are loose attaching. And here just one additional thing that they are loose in the complement of this Lagrangian. So now I want to formulate kind of three conjectures, kind of one wilder than the other. The first, I'm kind of pretty sure that this is true, and I'm almost see how one could prove this, but I don't know the proof. Okay, so the first conjecture. So I have a three statement, kind of I have the statement in the closed case, and I want to formulate them kind of, they are analog in the generative case. So one statement in the closed case is that when we have a that any almost complex manifold, if this handle body have homotopy type of half-dimensional thing, then it admit this Weinstein structure, more or less flexible Weinstein structure. So therefore, I claim the same thing true here. So suppose you take any Weinstein manifold, and you take any submanifold, N. So you take any embedded submanifold, not just take any smooth submanifold, which is formally Lagrangian, which means that I can take this embedding and I can kind of deform that to Lagrangian tangent plane and also with Legendrian boundary. So formally it looks like this thing. Then it is isotopic to Lagrangian submanifold with to flexible Lagrangian submanifold. So any submanifold you can realize as a flexible Lagrangian submanifold if topology allows you.
In W, any Weinstein manifold.
Any Weinstein manifold. Okay, so this is kind of one thing. The second thing that this flexible thing have no. The second thing that the flexible object have no symplectic topology. Namely, again, if you have two such objects, so you have this kind of L1 and L2, So we have now this is already flexible Lagrangian with Legendrian boundary, and they are formally Lagrangian isotopic. So that means that there is this isotopy together with this kind of covering deformation of Lagrangian homomorphism. Then they are Lagrangian isotopic in the class of Lagrangian, some kind of Hamiltonian even isotopic. I'm talking about only exact Lagrangian manifold. Hamiltonian isotopic, but of course boundary is moving. It's not with fixed boundary. Boundary moving via some Legendrian isotopy. So for this thing, I kind of have some idea how I would try to, yes.
Can you say again the hypothesis of conjecture two? Because what you said, it didn't look like it implies Legendrian boundary are isotopic, Legendrian isotopic. So do you ask that the boundary is loose or something?
No. No, I'm not. No, I'm not asking. No, the boundary is not loose. Boundary cannot be loose, because it's bound Lagrangian. Right. Yeah, boundary is not. Yeah, but so this is strong conjecture, of course.
So it would imply that there are no examples of Legendrian which are formally isotopic but not Legendrian isotopic and bound formally
formally isotopic Lagrangians, then they cannot. Okay, and then kind of like the wildest of all conjecture is the following, that in a flexible Weinstein manifold, All Lagrangian are flexible. So now I just remind that I consider only the closed, it does not kind of applicable to closed Lagrangian. I'm not saying any statement about closed Lagrangian because I require this property because I want them with my handle body picture, I want them to be loose in the complement of intersection. If it's a top dimension, then nothing's left. So there's no place for looseness.
Just to understand the definition of flexible, it's that.
What?
Just to understand the definition of flexible, it's that there exists one Morse function with these properties, or.
There exists one Morse function with there is one Morse function with this property. Again, this is a completely kind of open question, in subtle question. In closed case, we know that this flexibility condition for this Weinstein manifold can hold for one function and not for the other function. And kind of precisely this need to be understood. And similar is here.
Yeah, but you still think they're exactly right.
Yeah, everything exact. All Lagrangian.
In particular,
there are no closed ones. No, closed one could be, for instance, can I take a tangent bundle of SN? In principle, I could.
It's not flexible.
No, I'm saying the definition of flexibility prohibit closed, but it's not because they are exact. Yeah?
Well, if you're in a flexible Weinstein manifold, then supply homology should vanish. Right? By your exact sequence and so on.
Yeah, you mean for the last one?
Yeah, for
the last one, yes.
Yeah, so there are not going
to
be any closed.
No, yes, right.
So
yes. 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 So this would kind of in particular like take wonderful manifold which is a ball. So this is a flexible Weinstein manifold and you consider this and take a Lagrangian disk with Legendrian boundary. So if this kind of all conjecture true, that means that any two Lagrangian disks with Legendrian boundary are Lagrangian isotopic. This is not quite this nearby Lagrangian conjecture because I allow boundary to move, but kind of some step in this direction. So that's kind of what I just wanted to say, that that this kind of this nearby Lagrangian conjecture already after all work which were done using holomorphic curve theory, maybe the remaining part is complete H principle. So I think my time actually expired. So no more dreams.
Are there any questions?
Well, I just wanted to make sure about your result about the existence of cobordism. So if you take a closed manifold, which you'd like to have, which is almost complex and has a cohomology property symplectic, you certainly can't say there's a symplectic form on that. But if you remove two points, then you could make a symplectic form which is like infinity at one point and sort of an over-twisted contact structure on the other. But if you just remove one point, you couldn't say.
Not yes, yet. If I remove, not yet, yes.
But you'd like to be able to.
I would like to be safe.
Like you yes. think you should be able to get by with just removing one
yes.
point.
Okay. Well, you think it's kind of different. I hope.
You hope.
Okay. Because I cannot think because I don't know how to prove that, right?
Right, okay.
I tried to prove it and I couldn't, so maybe it's wrong.
Okay, but it's okay if you remove two points, then,
yes.
then
yes.
you're good.
Yes, I'm good.
You said something about an example of a flexible Weinstein domain with a non-flexible Weinstein subdomain.
Yes.
But not a sub-level set.
Sub-level set. So you have a Weinstein function, and for some smaller phi less or equal than c, for some the sub-level set is non-flexible. This is example of Murphy and Ziegler.
But does that mean that this function you're looking at is not the one that tells you that the larger?
No, not the one. Yes. So like you start with this one, then you do some kind of Hendel slide, and at some moment you end up with this strange situation.
Is that written down somewhere?
It is. The text was shown to me, but I don't know.
So it will appear. Mm-hmm.
In your dream, or
no, in my computer, so it's kind of exercise.
Dream of your computer.
Yes, I dream my computer, maybe. Okay.
Are there no other questions?
The author in the audience, who can be.
All right, so we're gonna reconvene not at 2, but at 2:30 today, following lunch. Let's thank Yasha again.